Hi, my name is Cindy, and welcome to our dielectric measurement laboratory at the ETS Foundation in Zurich. Accurate broadband dielectric measurement is crucial for my research. To study material behavior across a wide frequency range, I use DAK-TL2 for measurement from 4 MHz to 67 GHz. This is perfect for medium loss and lossy materials with dielectric loss larger than 1E-2, such as biological tissues, tissue-stimulating phantoms, and medium-loss plastics and ceramics. However, lately, I have also been asked to measure dielectric loss of low-loss materials and microwave frequencies. Until now, I used tools that were commercially available, but these were both inaccurate and cumbersome to use. Today, I received the new DAK resonator for testing. DAK-R is the first multi-frequency split-cylinder resonator. DAK-R claims that it measures the dielectric materials at 10, 17, 26, 35, and 45 GHz in one go, with an accuracy of better than 1% in dielectric permittivity and better than 1E-4 in dielectric loss. First, I connect the upper and lower halves of the cavity to the ports of the ZNA67 VNA and select the frequency points. As I am using a 67 GHz VNA, I can measure up to 45 GHz. Today, I want to characterize 10 samples of thin COP films. The sample can be any shape, as long as they are uniform in thickness, but not thicker than 3 mm, and fully cover the cavity. It is important that we know the thickness with high accuracy. Good thing I already have a precise and accurate instrumentation to measure the thickness, namely DAK-TL2. Having an uncertainty of less than 3 micrometer, I use DAK-TL2 not only to measure the thickness, but also to measure the dielectric properties of the sample. I measure the COP dielectric properties with the DAK-1.2E TL2 probe from 5 up to 67 GHz. For demonstration purposes, I will compare the data of one of the samples with the DAK-R results. The measured permittivity and loss are 2.35 and 2.2E-3 at 10 GHz and 2.34 and 1.6E-3 at 45 GHz, respectively. Now, I want to compare the results with DAK-R. First, I measure the empty resonator. I close the cavity without any samples and press measure empty. After a few seconds, the resonant frequency and Q factor for each mode appear in the results table. I can also view the S2-1 plots for each mode on the right side of the software interface and can verify that the cavity shows the same performance as during calibration by DAK-R. So, I'm all set and ready to go. I add COP to the sample list with the specified thickness. Then, I open the cavity and place the sample inside the gap and close it. I start the measurement by pressing Measure Sample. The measurement results for each material thickness combination appear in the corresponding tab. I can see the results in the table or a frequency plot, along with the S2-1 values for each mode. The measured permittivity remains constant at 2.34 across the measured frequencies. And for the loss, it is 4.1E-4 and 6.3E-4 at 10 GHz and 45 GHz, respectively. As expected, loss measurements with DAK-R provide more accurate readings. I'm very happy to see that the DAK-TL2 and DAK-R measurements are in complete agreement, with deviations well within the combined uncertainty of both methods. To compare the measurements between the 10 COP samples, I simply click the Compare button and select the COP 1 to 10 from the list. This feature is especially useful when checking variations between multiple samples. I found another useful feature in the DAK-R software. To check my measurement deviations from the reference values, I can add my material's target data to the dielectric database, enable the analysis button, and select the material from the drop-down list. This allows me to view deviation for both permittivity and loss. Finally, I click the Save button to store the results in DAK-R format, allowing me to review it later in the software and export it to Excel for post-processing. That's how easy it is to use the DAK-R for accurate and efficient dielectric measurements. I hope this video helps you understand the power of the DAK-TL2 and DAK-R combo for broadband dielectric characterizations. If you have any questions or would like to learn more, feel free to leave a comment below. For any further information, please check out the links in the description box down below. Thanks for watching and happy measuring!